For the week of April 25th, 2011, this is the Yokosuka Report on Channel 15, your place for news on the fleet, service members, and our community.
The Secretary of the Navy, the Honorable Ray Mabus, visited Fleet Activities Yokosuka to praise sailors and Marines for their sacrifices and service during humanitarian assistance and disaster relief efforts after a 9.0 magnitude earthquake and subsequent tsunami hit Japan on March 11th.
With the earthquake, with the tsunami, and what y'all did was to show the American people, show the Japanese people, and show the world what this force is capable of, because the world watched what you did. The world paid attention to the skill level, to the talent level, to the training, to the way you responded.
Sailors and Marines from several commands on the waterfront attended an all-hands call. Mabus also thanked the service members for not only the work they carried out during the relief efforts, but what they do on a daily basis.
So thank you from a very grateful nation. Thank you for everything that you do, not just in Tomodachi, but day to day, year in and year out.
Following the all-hands call, Mabus answered questions and concerns from the attendees about the current status and the future of the Navy. Petty Officer Bryan, Reckard, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
The USS George Washington returned to Commander Fleet Activities Yokosuka after conducting operations near the Japanese islands of Shikoku and Kyushu.
I think we really have a unique situation out here, you know, keeping the ties strong between us, the alliance. A lot of threats, you know, to the U.S. and to Japanese assets they have. So it's very good and very good opportunity to get the chance to do something like this. Only comes once in a lifetime. You know, we signed up for a job and we have to do our mission, so duty calls first. We do it for our families, do it for our country, so we're just glad we got the opportunity to do something like this.
The ship departed Yokosuka following the March 11th natural disaster to ensure the continuation of mission readiness and to support the U.S.-Japan alliance.
Especially now during, you know, what Japan has gone through. And it takes a special character to serve. And I think that I'm not proud only of him, but of all the men and women who serve and who are supporting Japan and who continue also to make time for their families.
Upon returning to Japan, George Washington will maintain a heightened state of readiness while committed to supporting peace and stability throughout the region. Petty Officer Michael Story, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.
On most Navy ships, there's a SITE TV rack. SITE stands for the Shipboard Information Training and Entertainment System. When a ship's SITE rack goes down, it can affect morale. So to prevent that, the Navy has specially trained Interior Communications Electricians, or ICs. Petty Officer Christopher Auker is the leading petty officer for the ICs attached to the Naval Media Center's SITE TV repair shop on Yokosuka Naval Base. They're in charge of repairing and maintaining all the SITE TV systems in the 7th Fleet area of responsibility, including over 20 ships. Auker says he's happy to help.
It's a good feeling, you know. It's one part of our job that's rewarding. You know, we don't always get credit for everything we do, but SITE is definitely it's a good feeling to be able to help people.
Repairing SITE racks and replacing parts is a service they provide to ships free of charge, because the systems don't actually belong to the ships. They're property of the Naval Media Center. Petty Officer Stuart Ringrose says he likes repairing SITE systems because it's a way for him to help his fellow sailors.
I like being able to help the ships out with TV. TV is like everything when you're underway. That's morale right there. And adding more channels, helping ships out with that helps morale on the ships.
With specialized ICs keeping the Navy's SITE TV systems up and running, sailors can rest assured they'll always have the latest movies, news, and command information while underway or in port. Petty Officer Brandon Shelander, Yokosuka Naval Base, Japan.